this, the vanities of women. Jokes apart, but I feel this is the swarasya, beauty of being a woman. She's very colorful. She's very full of life. You give a young man to handle a baby for 10 minutes. He may do it well, no doubt. You give that baby to a woman. It is 10 minutes of thorough celebration for her. Everything she does, puja. You see how the men do Sandhya Vandanam. It's a very pious and simple thing. But when we do Gauri Puja, the whole house is vibrant with that. We are so colorful when somebody else is getting married. So why are we like this? It is so the world over. This is called the Lavanya, the culture. It is not just vanity or show off. It is the beauty of the Jagannamata that lies within us. It is that Satya Shiva Sundara which manifests in that particular style. So a woman is by nature culture sensitive. We call it girly girly. Her dress, her hairstyle, her ways, her walk, her talk, her thought, everything is always emanating a kind of feminine grace. So with due respect to that, we have to empower her. Telling a woman to dress like a man, walk like a man, become like somebody else is absolute abuse to her real worth. She has to be a woman. Why should a lotus become a jasmine? Why should a jasmine become a lotus? If you want a lotus to become a jasmine and uproot it from water and put it on land, it'll just dry off. We are damaging the inherent nature of somebody by trying to change them. That is what today's education is doing. It's trying to make us change to somebody, just blindly ape somebody. That is where the real worth of being a woman is somewhere getting lost. There's a kind of a cultural identity crisis we see. Next is she's emotionally very influential. The mood of a Grihini, of a woman, means a lot to the whole ambience. If the mother of the family, wife of the family is out of mood, it shows in the whole house. There is something wrong with that house. Kannadadalli heltivi grahana badadange anta. Something is wrong there. Because if she is cheerful, she is smiling, she radiates that around. And there's no dispute about this, that she definitely has a lot of influence on everybody's emotions around her. And most importantly, the realization of the Bharatiya Samskriti is that woman is essentially the mother. When I say mother, I'm not talking about biological motherhood. You have a kid, you are a mother. Even that is very great. I understand I'm a mother too. But the real motherhood is a part of our psyche. It's a spiritual motherhood. You see a 5-year-old child, give her a doll, she becomes a mother immediately.